Our Passion History continues this evening with a reading of Passion History number 6 as found as a bulletin insert. Passion reading number 6. When the soldiers crucified Jesus, they took his clothes, dividing them into four shares, one for each of them, with the undergarment remaining. This garment was seamless, woven in one piece from top to bottom. They said to one another, "This happened that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said,
'They divided my garments among themselves and cast lots for my clothing.'"
So this is what the soldiers did. And sitting down, they kept watch over him there. Those who passed by hurled insults at him, shaking their heads and saying, "In the same way, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders mocked him.
He saved others, but he can't save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, that we may see him. He trusts in God. Let God rescue him now if he wants him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" One of the criminals who hung there for him also said,
"Don't you fear God, since you are under the same sentence? We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother,
"Dear woman, here is your son."
And to the disciple,
"Here is your mother."
From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which means, "My God, why have you forsaken me?"
When some of those standing near heard this, they said,
"Listen, he's calling Elijah."
Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said,
"I am thirsty."
A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said,
"It is finished."
Jesus called out with a loud voice,
"Father, into your hands I commit my spirit."
With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. At that time, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tombs broke open, and the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tombs, and after Jesus' resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many people. When the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, "When all the people who had gathered to witness this sight saw what took place, they beat their breasts and went away. Some women were watching from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and the younger, and of Joses and Salome. In Galilee, these women had followed him and cared for his needs. Many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem were also there."